This part of the campaign about which you're speaking today is simple. It is aimed at depriving the regime of the revenues that it uses to spread death and destruction around the world. Our ultimate aim is to compel Iran to permanently abandon its well-documented outlaw activities and behave as a normal country. These sanctions hit at core areas of Iran's economy. They are necessary to spur changes we seek on the part of the regime. We expect to issue some temporary allotments to 8 jurisdictions, but only because they have demonstrated significant reductions in their crude oil and cooperation on many other fronts and have made important moves towards getting to 0 crude oil importation. These negotiations are still ongoing. We expect, have reduced Iranian crude oil exports by more than 1 million barrels even before these sanctions go into effect. This massive reduction since May of last year is 3 to 5 times more than what many analysts were projecting when President Trump announced our withdrawal from the deal back in May. We exceeded our expectations for one simple reason. Maximum pressure means maximum pressure. We're very confident that our sanctions will be incredibly effective. And frankly, I can prove that already. As I stated, the Iranian economy today is already feeling the effects of this. It's already feeling the effects of this effort, not because the sanctions have snapped back. That won't occur until on Monday, but because the world and Iran knew this was coming. We're counting on the Iranian people to have the opportunity, and we are working towards allowing the Iranian people to have the opportunity to have the government they want, a government that doesn't take wealth from their country and spend it on malign activity around the world. These sanctions are far tougher than the sanctions that have ever been imposed on the Islamic Republic of Iran. That is why they are so desperate to find ways to circumvent it.
Any financial institution, company, or individual who evades our sanctions risk losing access to the U.S. financial system and the ability to do business with the United States or U.S. companies. We are intent on ensuring that global funds stop flowing to the coffers of the Iranian regime.